foot. The trappers captured the birds using traditional methods. The trapper would camouflage himself behind a tree or in a hole dug into the ground, covered with leaves and branches. Using a pigeon tied to a long thread as a lure, waiting until the falcon attacked the helpless pigeon, upon which the trapper would slowly and silently draw the thread in towards the trap. As the falcon approaches the hole, a brief battle would then ensue between trapper and falcon, as he used his bare hands to capture the bird, trying to avoid the sharp beak and deadly talons. With time came progress and the introduction of the camel and then four wheels as transport, widening the hunt. Falconers also invented a handmade trapping noose, constructed from finely woven strands of metal and cunningly covered in thin strands of thread to stop it from flashing in the bright sunlight. The noose would be attached to the back of a live pigeon, which is used as bait. The net is attached to several hoops bound by horsehair. The falconer and his friends would lie and wait for a hungry falcon to capture. Once the pigeon was attacked, the men would surround the net, shouting in loud voices to create confusion. Head to subdue it. Before hooding the bird, the trapper would attach to its feet a length of thread known as alsabog. Night trapping was also favored once motor vehicles were introduced to the region. The trapper would use the blinding light of his vehicle's headlights to disable the falcon's vision. And then the trapper would use the roar of the engine to cover the sound of his stealthy footsteps. The trapper will then capture the falcon using a net deep enough to contain the bird. Another way to catch a falcon is to make a trap using a pigeon as bait, surrounded by a large net.